Hi, so it's this 8th of August, and we've been working quite hard with our mixes over the last 7 days. So I thought today we'd give you a nice yoga flow just to help ease off any aching muscles and just allow the body to open. So I'd like you to get back onto your mat or wherever you're going to use. Bring yourself into a child's pose, so that's hips back to the heels, stretch your arms forward. And breathing. I just want you to connect with yourself and remind yourself that when you breathe in, that's your tension, and when you breathe out, that's your release. Okay, so that's your space that you're creating. So up onto your hands and knees, spread your fingers nice and wide, knees under the hips, hands under your shoulders, and a cat stretch up. So curl up, really squeeze in. Lift the spine up, head down, neck relaxed. And reversing that movement, tummy down, hips up, shoulders down, chin up. Gazing up as well. And release. Take your toes under, lift your knees up, breathe in. And breathe out, hips back and up. Head down between your arms, arms nice and straight. Middle fingers facing forward. And pedal out nice and gently. One heel down, then the other. Just getting into your back of your legs, your lower back. Okay, well done. So you can place your knees down onto the mat now. And then step your right foot forwards, or you can just step, go straight into that, step your right leg forwards. So breathing in and breathing out, just coming up onto that back knee. Square your hips off so you have a line, so this back hip might need to come forwards and the hip of the bent knee will go back. Breathing in, stretch up, all the way into the sides of your body. Breathing out, you're going to rotate away and place that hand on the floor. Take your hand into your lower back, twist round. And then breathing in, stretch up. And breathing out, take the arm down to the floor. Other hand on the mat. Turn, face, breathe in. Hand in your lower back, round as far as you can. And stretch the arm up, reaching to the sky. I've got my eyes closed because the sun is right in my eyes. I'm going to look down at my foot, connecting with the floor with my base hand, connecting with the sky with my top hand. And release that down. Okay, so we can lift the back knee, take a low lunge, lift the back knee as much as you can. And big push on that foot to bring yourself into your forward bend. Other side, so back leg, back, low lunge. It's nice and steady with these movements. Okay, so we're not rushing anything here. Taking our time, there's no tempo, there's no speed, there's no repetitions. Breathing in, breathing out. There's a connection that you find with your body, with your breath. With your flow, breathing in, stretching up, and breathing out, taking the arm down to the mat, to rotate, back, base hand on the floor, top hand up to the sky, breathing through the side of your body, you can turn your head and look down, stretching your neck, and reverse that. Take yourself the other direction, rotate as much as you can, and take the arm up to the sky. Breathe in, stretch up, breathe out, find space. Look down. And then take your hands up. Hands on either side of your foot, and bring the back knee off the floor. So that's your low lunge, really getting into your stretch of your hip flexor, your quads. And then big push on that back toe to bring your feet together, forward bend down. Lovely, well done. Soften the knees slightly and just roll yourself up into a stand. Breathing and stretching up and up. Leaning back slightly. And breathing out all the way down. So every stretch is as far as you can, but nice and relaxed. Step back right leg. Bring yourself into a high lunge with that. So low lunge, high lunge, just hands off the floor. You can bend your back knee and then straighten it just to get that position. Square your hips off, sinking down, and now stretch your arms up. Breathing in, so you've got that length in the side of your body. And we're just gonna rotate that around, see if we can really hold that position. Heel in the floor if you can, and then just bring it back up. I'll do that a couple of times. Same side, so down and stretch out. Look back at your hand if you can. Keep the balance. You can do this with the knee down if you find it a bit difficult with the leg up. And swing along your toe. You're going to see the back of my body now. I'm taking a warrior. So arms, just check shoulder height. Reaching, same idea, hand to the floor and hand to the sky. Back, hitting the floor, looking up at your hand. And you can bend the elbow slightly and reach it over. And down. Really super opening, really nice and relaxed. And square your hips off. Get into your hamstring. And then take the back leg back, front leg back. Raise it up, three-legged down dog. Strong shoulder blades. Top knee as high as you can. Bend your elbow. Sorry, bend your knee. And you can keep your breathing still. Really focused. And then ease that foot back down into your down dog. You can bring a high plank. You can do knees to the floor, chest, and roll forwards and up. Head down. Tuck your back toes under. Lift your knees up. And bring yourself into your down dog again. Going to do that with the other side, so I'd just like you to spring your foot and your knee up towards your chest and step the foot forwards. So you're in your low lunge and bring yourself up into your high lunge. Remember, you can bend that back knee and straighten it, sinking down. Just make sure your knee is over your ankle there, stretching up, breathing in and breathing out. This time we're going to twist away, so all the way around that way, keeping the focus and the balance, and then arm back up, and again, so down, and then, and back up, arms up. Well done. You're going to take a rotation into your warrior here. And you're going to reach forward, hand down, and rotate. And then raise your arm up. So the arm is stretching up to the sky. The hand is down to the floor. Just checking your position. All the way up. Soften your elbow. Take your arm over. You can have a look at your fingertips. really reaching. Oh, go with the movement and the breath. That's lovely. Well done. Hands on either side of your foot, low lunge. And you're going to straighten your front leg. Square your hips off. Getting into your hamstrings. Bend the knee again. Push that front leg back and up into the air. Your three-legged down dog. Breathing in, breathing out. Heel down to the mat. Soften the knee at the top. Little rotation. Find your ankle. Breathing in, breathing out. Opening, reaching, extending. And then take that back down into your down dog. 2 feet on the floor. And then bring yourself into a high plank. This is option two coming up. So you can go knees and chest, or you can go full chaturanga all the way down. Hover, and then through. Or you can just go to the floor if you can't do that hover. You do what you can. Knees to the floor. Child's pose, breathing in and breathing out. And a little rock from side to side. Okay, well done. So you're on your knees now. Kneeling on your knees. Or you can put a cushion underneath if you want to do that. So we're just going to open the side of our body here. So you're going to reach over to one side with your hand. Keep your chest rotated, a little bit rotated. And your hip down on your heel. And you're going to breathe and stretch up. And you're going to breathe and stretch over. And just allow that sinking. A couple of breaths. This is what you might need. You might need a support underneath your elbow there, or you might not even be able to get that far. This is what you can. I just want you to focus on this sinking down, this opening feeling that you're getting from the side of your body here. Wherever you may be within this position, you might just be there with your arms straight. But I've got more length, so I'm just going there. And up and over. So we'll do the other side. So it's nice and steady. It's that real connection. So we're not going pump, pump, pump with the HIIT workout. We're going down, finding the base, finding the connection, feeling the fibres stretching and opening for you. With your out-breath, sinking down into it. And with these movements, you'll really notice what's going on in your body. The difference that you might have between one side and the other side. Remembering when you breathe in, that's the tension. And when you breathe out, that's the release. And again, the length that you're creating when you move every time you move something. And every time you take a breath in and a breath out. Yeah. Well done. Okay. So let's sit down now. And I'd like you to lie down actually. Let's just go down onto our backs. Been a lot of standing work we've been doing. Feet flat on the floor and lift yourself up into a bridge. Now if you can do a shoulder stand, we're going to do a shoulder stand. And if you feel a bit uncomfortable about doing a shoulder stand, I'd just like you to lie on your back, lower back into the mat with your legs extended in the air and just hold that position. And you can move your legs out, in, with your ankles, or just enjoy having your legs in the air. For those of you that would like to try the shoulder stand, your feet on the floor, lift your hips up, roll your shoulders underneath your body and clasp your hands behind your back and just extend your arms. Your neck is nice and long. I wouldn't suggest trying this if you've never done it before. If you're confident, then yep, go for it. So this is your bridge. And then come down out of your bridge. Elbows are still in, knees come up off the floor. I'd like you to just take your knees forwards just a little bit, like a little rocking sensation. And when you're ready, you can push down on your elbows and bring yourself up. And your hands are up your back. Shoulders down away from your ears. And one leg extended and the other leg. So get your position. Hips are forwards, bottom squeezed tight, extended up like you're reaching up towards the sky with your feet. Your feet are your head. The shoulders are your feet. Breathing. And you can move your legs out to the side. So those of you that are down, flat on the floor, you can move your legs out to the side. You can bring them back together. The shoulder stand moving, legs can go one leg down, breathe in. And breathe out, leg up. Breathe in, leg down. And open and release. And leg up. Good. And you can go into a plow. If you feel comfortable, you're going into a plow. Take both legs back. If you've got feet touching on the floor, toes moving towards your head, really get onto your shoulder blades, onto your shoulders. Reach your arms up towards your feet. You're going to feel this tight in your lower back, maybe even all the way into your neck, depends on what's going on in your lower back. Bend your knees so your knees go around your ears or your head. Point your toes and just rest your arms on top of your calf muscles. Breathing. Now most of you might find this quite tight, maybe a little bit uncomfortable, but just try and hold that and go with your breath. That's lovely. Take your hands away and slowly, like super, super slowly, roll down. Try and keep your spine on the floor. So your stomach muscles have to work quite hard to keep that there as you roll down. All those stomach exercises we've been doing should help that. Nice and controlled. And feet down on the floor. Arms down. We're in a nice position here. If you want to straighten your legs here, we can have a moment in corpse pose. Just taking some nice deep breaths in and out. Have your eyes closed if you want to there. Just focusing. And if you're doing this in your own time, then there's nothing, you can stay, nothing saying you have to move. You can stay here for as long as you want, if you found that connection. But I'm going to move because I can't stay here. I'm on record. Okay, so I'm going to bring myself up, lower back in the mat, up into sitting. I'm going to bring my feet up into my boat position, which we've been doing in our HIIT workouts. And our arms extended. And we're going to do five, okay, so just a little bit in here. So five, bring it in. Not so super fast. Four, bring it in nice and controlled. Three, bring it in. Two, bring it in. Last one, bring it in. Good. Hold your ankles, soles of your feet together. I'm going to come and face you now. And you're going to sit up nice and tall. Just hold on to the very bottom of your feet. Arms nice and straight. And tension in your arms because you're sitting up nice and straight. Chin down to your chest. Feel the stretch in the back of the neck. Deep breath in and breathe out. Tilting your head over to one side. Lift your head up. I've got my eyes closed just because helps me focus more when I have my eyes closed. all about what we're feeling inside when we do our yoga stretching. We're not whizzing around, looking around, we're looking inside ourselves, how we're feeling. And gently release that. Well done. Hands behind you, feet on the floor, and you're just going to bring yourself gracefully, if you can, onto your soles of your feet or onto your toes if you can't get your heels down. Maybe take your legs a little bit wider. Go into your garland pose, your Buddha pose. And if those of you who can do crow, want to try something crowy, you can do it now. I'm just going to show you from the side. So we're in our garland pose. You're going to place your hands down. You're going to look forwards. Your elbows are going to be slightly bent. Your knees are up by your in your armpits. And you're taking your feet off the floor, big toes touching, looking forward so you're not diving onto the floor with your head, pushing the floor away with your hands to stay, and then place your feet gracefully down on the floor into your forward bends, down, take your arms up behind you, reach them up nice and high, up, up, up. And and roll yourself up nice and gently. Super. You're standing. Nice deep breath in. Stretch up. And bring yourself back down through the midline. Heart center. I'm going to bend my knees. I'm going to bring myself onto the floor here. Point my toes. You don't have to do that. You can stay standing. The 8th of August, it's the Lion's Gate portal opening today. So if you know what I'm talking about, then enjoy your day. If not, then maybe you can look it up. All right, there we go. Have a lovely day, and see you tomorrow for more.